Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
God is good.
All the time.
Every hand's lifted up. Every eye closed. Begin to see Jesus. Every eye closed. Whisper something to him.
Oh, we came.
You can't live the same way you came.
Oh, we came.
Talk to me, God.
I came to see
talk
God.
To me. Someone talk to me.
Oh, Jesus.
We give you thanks.
Jesus, Jesus, Jesus. What a wonder you are.
Oh,
wonderful.
The love of Zion.
I can't wait to be there. I don't know what excites wait. That is why I'm waiting. That when I get there, I will see him as he is. And I will go down and I will worship him. And I said, Daddy, I worshiped you when I never saw you. But now I can see you face to face. Jehovah, I cannot wait. I don't know what excites you. I don't know. But I want you to come alive for God. Because there was some secret in God. And when you catch it, no one can discourage you. No one. No one. No one. If you don't know how to worship God here, start. Because when you get to heaven, you'll be disappointed. Yeah? Worship is work. It's work. But you have to do it with gladness.
That's it.
Yeah? Yes. I am hoping that by the message of the Ayah, I will qualify. Hallelujah. That I will be able to stand up before the Elohim. Yeah. Ah, Jesus. And learn from those who went ahead of us. That together with the 24 elders, the host of angels, and the multitude of the redeemed, I will make obeisance to the king and say, yes, sir, I have come. I don't know what you are waiting for, but I can't wait to stand before the Ayah. There is something about the presence of God. It's only through worshipers who are allowed to approach the presence of God. True worshipers. I want you to learn how to worship God and things will become easy.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
I want you to believe what I'm telling you. If you know how to worship God, you don't need to fast for 30 days to see miracles. That's things right. Happen. Yeah? Amen. I am telling you, this is the secret. Amen. There was a company who was owing me, and I called them. And they said, oh, this is what we agreed. So whatever money we've taken, we're not giving it back to you. And they've been taking the money from my account for about 7 months or 8 months, and I've not been checking, so I didn't know. I said, okay, you do not take my money, you bring it back. And I hung up. A week later, thereabout, I saw an email. And the director said, we apologize. We send all the money back.
Amen.
I am telling you something. The power works. Yes? There is power inside of you. When you connect, the enemy doesn't stand a chance. And who is he? That says a thing and it comes to pass. When your God has not sanctioned, when your God has not sanctioned, who? Who? No one. If you know how to worship God, I am telling you, when you begin to speak, heaven will say, yes, sir, what do you want? Heaven will respond to you.
Yes.
Oh, heaven will respond.
Yes.
Oh, heaven will respond.
Yes.
Heaven is for you.
Oh, yes.
They are waiting for you to give commands and things will happen. Yes. But you need to understand the principle. You need to hold your hold. You see, he said, enter his gates with what?
Thanksgiving.
And what's the second one?
Thanksgiving.
Okay, so you know the secret.
Yes, sir.
So you need to apply the secret. And it works.
Yeah.
It works. Yeah. I don't struggle for 7 days. You now at this point I'm praying, I don't have time for the enemy. Because my focus is the Ayah.
Yes,
and when you take care of God's business, forget about your business.
Yes, sir.
Believe what I'm telling you. If you try it, it will work. Yeah. Yeah. It will work.
Yeah.
Oh, it will work.
Yeah.
It will work.
Yes, sir.
There was no limitation to prayer. Somebody called me from the US and said, my in-law has been persecuting me. I said, do you want her to die? She said, no. I said, okay. Go on the phone and tell me exactly what you want to happen where. And when you finish, call me back and something will happen. And she knows that when I declare, something will happen. This is what I'm talking about. That people, know when they come to you, you are the last door. Things happen when you speak. Yeah? That is why Jesus died. That we, through him, will. You see, this is what Jesus said. He said, if you believe in me, the things I do, and I didn't see Jesus when he was passing through, so I can only read what has been recorded. He said, the things I do, you will do also. He didn't end there. He said, greater works shall thou do. And I I'm still thinking about the greater work Jesus is talking about. Because when I look at the account of Jesus, the things he did, I've not even done 100. And he said that greater work shall we do if we believe in him. What are we sitting down doing? We are wasting power. And the enemy is scared of power. When you begin to release power, they will leave you alone. A Christian without power, the enemy is not scared of you. It's wrong. When the enemy knows that when he knocks at your door, Jesus will appear. He won't try. He won't try. He won't. He won't. No, he won't. I tell myself, I said, if you are my friend and you are a witch or you are a wizard, it's your problem. Because when you try to enter where I live, I won't tell you anything. No. Then I am will visit you there. It is straightforward. Listen, you should make sure that God, the I am, is occupying where you live.
Amen.
So that when the enemy is knocking at the door, yes, it is the I am who opens the door. It's for you. Amen. Give God the best place in your house, your room, wherever, and say, Daddy, this one is for you.
Amen.
Yeah? When the enemy knocks, you don't need to bother. You come to my place and you are knocking. I won't even bother. Holy Ghost is there.
Amen.
He will slay you.
Amen.
That's what you need to do.
Yes,
you don't need to be running away from your enemies. No. You don't need to. No. You need to run to God. And when they know that you are closer to God, they won't dare. They will not. They will not. Listen. We need to take this city.
Yeah.
For God.
Yeah. Yeah.
If you mean business, and you want to go to heaven, happy, let's do it together.
Yes.
Because there was a lot of work to be done. I know we started planning for Christmas. People ask me what I mean for Christmas. I say, you know what, a very long time, I've not even had the time to sit down and think. I said, wait, I am re-strategizing and I'll get back to you.
Uh-huh.
Because I have told God that this month, we have to win this city.
Yes.
You see, I had the testimonies when you were talking about this radio thing. It's not even radio, we are going on television. We'll do everything.
Yeah.
We'll do everything, don't worry. Yeah? But you need to train yourself. You need to be ready.
Yes.
Because you are the people who are going to do the work.
Yeah?
Who will empower you and you will do the work.
Yeah.
And you make God proud.
Yeah.
You see, there was something Paul said. And anytime I listen to that, it gladdens my heart. He said, my glory is that I will see you standing for the Ayah.
Hallelujah.
That is the only reason why I'm here. That when the trumpet sound, we'll be able to account for what we did with our lives. It's not the amount of money you have in your account. Your life. Does your life count for something? When people see you, do they say, I want to be like that brother or that sister? Or they say, wallahi, as for that sister, I won't go to church. We need to change certain things about our behaviors. Now, when people see us, they should desire to be like us.
Yeah.
I will tell them, you know what? You're trying to be like me. I'm trying to be like Jesus.
Hallelujah.
I'm not there yet.
Amen.
Point them to the source.
Amen.
Our life can minister to people.
Yes.
Let's do it the right way.
Amen.
God has entrusted you with something.
Yes.
But let's appreciate it and let's use it.
Amen.
Is that a man's gift? We'll do what? We'll make room for him. Not only that. He said it will bring you before noble, before great men.
Amen.
You need that. The privilege God has given me, I am standing before you.
Amen.
You are noble people. You are people Jesus does not joke with. He died for you.
Amen.
You are noble.
Yes.
And you need to use the same challenge and say, you know what? Goodness me, I need to stand before great men and women.
Yes.
Tell them how good the I am is.
Amen.
Yeah? Stop sleeping 8 and 10 hours. If you sleep less, you won't give. Yeah? When you wake up, pray for someone. Stop praying for yourself. Learn this strategy. It works. Pray for people. Pray for the church. Pray for your pastor. Pray for your leaders. When you do that, God will raise an army.
Amen.
To pray for you.
Amen.
It is true.
Yes.
Yes?
Yes, sir.
Can you imagine if the number here are praying for you 1 minute every day? Can you imagine what will happen to you? But because we are are selfish, we are self-centered. We are always God, give me, give me, give me. It's only about me. It's only about me. You forget others. Mention their names before they are young and say, Daddy, do something about the life of that sister. Because when they prosper, the church prospers. You need to do that. Yeah, stop being selfish. Say, I don't have time for myself. Really, make time for others. And God will give you the time you don't have. You have 24 hours. If you give that to God, He will give you more. And it is true. He will give you more. I want us to do something. I want us to speak to someone about Christ. You believe in Jesus, that's why you are sitting here. I want to make you angry that you can speak to someone and say, Sister, God loves you.
Amen.
It's good enough. God loves you. That one alone will cause someone to think. Yeah, there were some friends I had. When I spoke to them about Jesus Christ, they would get angry. I speak to them now and they've changed.
Amen.
And some of them will be asking, oh, where are you ministering today? What am I saying? Sow the seed. And God Himself will do the rest.
Amen.
You know, I want you to get to heaven and God will be proud of you. I don't want God to go to the corner and say, thank you very much, you made it. I want God to summon the angelic host to everyone and say, hey, everyone must wait because my son has come. I left him here with the enemy, but he has managed to conquer and now he's here. It is time for me to reward him. That is what I want. And that is what I keep telling people. I said, when you go to church, leave the front seat. You don't leave the front seat.
No, sir.
I always want the back seat.
Yes, sir.
That's the way I am. Yeah? I am not tall. I'm not big. But I always want the back seat. Because when you do something good, they will call you from the back.
Yes.
Everybody will be waiting. Yes. And you will see. Because, you see, he said, you serve God in secret. What will he do when he decides to reward you? Open. You see, open. So you don't need to do anything. Just follow the principles and the Ayah will reward you. Yeah? Forget about the front seat. Leave it for those who want it. Sit there. Yeah? I want to be there. The last. When the Ayah will trumpet and say, Yehovah, come. That's what I'm talking about. And everybody will be standing, waiting and saying, Yehovah, he made it. He made it. Yeah, when God is reading your accolades and everything, everybody will be like, wow, did he do that? Did she do that? Yes, this is the time to invest.
Yes.
Because there was a time coming that book will be closed.
Amen.
I don't know why you are here. But if you came here because you want to change, then it is time to forget about your problems and think about God. He created you. He cares. You can't keep asking God for food. Yeah? You eat for today. You need to eat for tomorrow. Let's do something that God will be proud of us. Once upon a time, God did something about Brother Job. He said, have you considered? Have you considered Job? Can God boast about you? Can God recommend you for promotion? Most of us will fail. God knows He can't trust us. When He allowed the enemy to visit us 1 second, Jehovah, heaven must be standing waiting because we will fall. But we need to come to a place where they are young, will be confident in us and say, have you considered sister so, so and so? And He knows that it doesn't matter what you go through, you will still stand.
Amen.
And defend Him.
Amen.
That's what God is counting on. And I know you can do it.
Amen.
That is why we are having a chat.
Amen.
I want us to work together. Make God proud. And the Ayah will come through for us.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Let me read one scripture. In Isaiah 38. Please. Isaiah 38. Isaiah 38.
I read from one. They said in those days, Hezekiah was sick and near death. And Isaiah, the prophet, the son of Amos, went to him and said to him, "Thus saith the Lord, set your house in order, for you shall die and not live." Hallelujah.
Amen.
If I come tell you this message, you will curse me. And you will curse me. He said, "How dare you? Who do you think you are?" Hezekiah could have done the same thing, but he didn't do that. He said, "Thank you very much, man of God. But it was someone who gave you the word. I am going to the source and I want to negotiate with the source."
Amen.
When you receive testimonies and prophecies, don't be chasing the men of God. Don't. They will deceive you. Because by the time you come, they are not operating under the anointing. But because you are pushing them, they'll tell you something. Go to the source. If it is God who gave you the word, you can negotiate with God. Yes, stop following people who deceive you. You have free access. 301, how many days do we have in a year? Is it 65 or 66? Whatever. Yeah? You have that access to the Ayah. When you know, it shall be open unto you. Go to him and say, "Ayah, I have come. Left God. Daddy, I am sorry. Let the message be lifted on my behalf. But give me another chance." And the Ayah will listen to you. Dorcas was saved. According to the scriptures, she died. But the church said, "No, we will not allow her to go." When you are sick and the message is delivered to bishop or whoever, will he organize the church and say, "Let's fast 24/7. This sister cannot go." Yeah? Some of you, when you are sick and you call, nobody will answer the phone. Because you are not committed to the things of God. And it's a fact. Yeah? If you are committed to something or someone, that thing or that person will be committed to you.
Yes.
Sow a seed.
Yes.
That on that day when you need it, God can look at your account and say, "Not so."
Amen.
You see, when you have a deposit in heaven, yes, you can petition heaven and say, "Not so."
Amen.
Yeah? You can petition heaven and heaven will listen to you.
Amen.
Or heaven will listen.
Yes.
But you need to make sure that you have something there, that when you go there, the Ayah will say, "According to the archives, Jehovah, I need to remember this sister." Do something when you are still alive. Yeah? Don't dress nicely, come and sit here. When you go out there, you are wild. Do something that God will be proud of you. You have free access to the throne room, but make good use of it. Don't let anyone deceive you. They said, God said you should set your house in order. You are going to die. In the end, they said, the sickness, you will not recover. And we always hear bad news. And what do? We criticize people. We fight with everyone. Bishop, this one, I don't think you heard from God. Really? He killed it and he made it alive. So God can choose to do whatever he wants. Yeah? It is up to you to go and negotiate with him.
Amen.
Can you put yourself in a place like Abraham, that if God wants to destroy someone, he said, "I want you to destroy that brother. What do you think?" That God will seek a second opinion concerning the person. We need covenants with the Ayah. Covenant. Build it up. Then you can say, "Jehovah, because of the covenant I have with you, respond." And that's it. It is done. It is done. Yeah, it is done. When you enter into a covenant with God, God will keep it. The unfaithful one is us. And God is faithful. Even when we remain unfaithful, the Ayah is still faithful.
Amen.
Don't run away from God. Okay? It's not that scary as we made him to be. He's a loving father. When you go to him, you can negotiate with him. And I want you to do that because he's there waiting for us to help us. Don't run away. He said, "You will die." He said, "You're
I want to talk to the Ayah. I want to change these predictions. And you know what? When I was coming today, God was telling me that as a matter of fact, Hezekiah, he got additional, extended life. That originally, that wasn't what God planned. So when God told him he was going to die, that is what God had ordained that he was going to leave. He said, you have finished your work here, come to your rest. Okay? But God decided one reason or the other to go and speak to a man and say, son, put your house in order, you're going to die. You think it's everyone who do that? It's because of your covenant, your heart. You know? And God liked challenges. And said, you know what, daddy, I don't think I've done well for myself, but I'm happy to go. But you know what? I think some brethren are suffering. I think you need me. Let's enter into a covenant. Give me a bit more time. Let me finish my work.
Hallelujah.
And God said, you know what? I won't give you 1 year. I'll give you 15 years in addition. Jehovah, 15 years. 15 years. What can you not get from the Ayah? When you read that somewhere, why? The account of Elkanah.
Yes.
Elkanah. It tells you something interesting. According to the scriptures, it was God who sealed the womb of Hannah.
Yes.
And when I read, I said, God, why would you do that? You said, none shall be barren on the land. Why did you do that? You see, the person sitting next to you, you see them and you are jealous because of the way they dress, the car they drive, and everything they do. You see, those people are in your life to challenge you to get to your next level.
Yes.
Yeah. Take it in good faith. Don't fight them. Go to God and fight God and say, God, why? Stop fighting people. Yeah. Go to God and say, daddy, do something. You know I love you. Do something.
Amen.
Stop fighting the penitents. They will help you.
Yes.
They will continue to grieve you. Yes. And when you see them in church, Jehovah, hey, they are the leaders. They dress nicely. I mean, listen, if you need them, they are there. But they are not close to Yaya. They are according to the busy bodies. They are everywhere, but they are nowhere.
Hallelujah.
You need to maintain your focus and say, Jehovah, it is time to show me mercy. The message of God. I don't need the message of a man. A man will do something today and they will expect you to worship them for the rest of your life.
Yes.
Who are they? Jehovah, I will lift lamentation before their God.
Amen.
I will petition heaven.
Amen.
Heaven will come through.
Amen.
You need to take advantage of the answers God has given us. Yeah? And I have every right to remain married. According to the scriptures, the husband loved her more than her all. Yeah? And the husband was trying to say, you know what? You don't need to give me 10 children. Just forget it. I love you. You know that. She said, no.
Mm-hmm.
I have a covenant with Yaya.
Amen.
And something must happen. And according to the scriptures, because she was grieved in her heart, and she could have decided to murder people, she went to the Ayah. And I'm something I like. The high priest. Ella. He missed it. He saw Hannah. And according to the scriptures, he thought that Hannah was drunk. Listen. Men of God are just leaders. Yeah? You are also a leader. When I stand here, heaven is open. When I sit next to you, we are on the same level. That's the only difference. When you avail yourself, God can use you. Yeah? So what I'm trying to say is that don't expect people to come and tell you this is what God said, your birthday is this. You have free access.
Oh yes.
She went to the Ayah and said, daddy, you know what? I have checked and I've realized that you have a big issue. You have a big issue. You have a big vacuum. And you can use me to fill that vacuum. Let's enter into a covenant. Give me a son and I will give you a king's anointer, Dios. Somebody who installed kings. And God sat there and said, Jehovah, this one, she has gotten it. She has my number.
Hallelujah.
She has my direct access.
Yes.
He said, lady, we have a deal.
Amen.
And God came to. And the lady said, throughout his life, he shall be loaned unto the ayah.
Amen.
When you give back, loan them to the ayah.
Hallelujah.
Loan them.
Amen.
And because of that, God gave her extra 5 kids. You see, you can never outgive God. You can never. You can never. When you give God something, God will work with it and he will give you more than triple.
Yeah.
Hannah had one. That was Samuel. But she gave Samuel back to the originator. And he said, because you have 10 days, you're over, you have passed heaven, I will give you 5 more.
Amen.
5 more.
Amen.
5 more. How many do you want? How many do you want? Enter into a covenant with God.
Amen.
A covenant that will stand the test of time.
Amen.
Yeah? I want us to go somewhere. I want us to get to a state where God will be proud of us.
Amen.
Let's make God proud. We have answers. We have answers. Let's do something.
Amen.
Yeah? I'll tell you this. One day I was traveling. And I was speeding. And I was driving like 100, over 100 miles an hour. And the car did not somersault. The car suspended like this.
Wow.
Rotated, not 360, 720. Was falling on the A11. Another car sparked. It went past me when I was suspended. The car landed at the edge. Nothing happened to the car. Nothing happened to me. Yeah. This is a destiny child. I am telling you something.
Amen.
That you see, if you are destined to live, it doesn't matter what the enemy does, you will live.
Yes.
Oh, you will live.
Yes.
Oh, you will live. Oh, you will live. Amen. I think it was a Monday, and the Sunday I've gone to preach like in 2 places, and I was going to work on Monday, and God knew that I had a covenant with him. He had to protect me in the way. Whether you are guilty or not, God said you are not guilty.
Amen.
That's it.
Amen.
That's it. It is only God who can exempt you. It doesn't matter what the lawyer says. If God said not guilty, it is not guilty.
Amen.
The enemy can bring their petition. All the I am will do is to turn to the blood of Jesus. And Jesus will say, Daddy, remember what I did. I lift up the mercy seat.
Hallelujah.
And the I am will say, pardon.
Amen.
You have all this access. Let me tell you what Jesus is doing now. He's interceding for you. Yeah, if you didn't know that, he's interceding for you, so use him. Use him. I'm not saying you should be driving 100 or whatever, but I am saying that perhaps if something goes wrong because you have a covenant with Yahya, he has to protect that covenant.
Amen.
He has to. I remember when I came to this country, before I entered, I was detained at the airport the whole day for 8 hours. Yeah. And they put me in a cold room. Very cold. And I was from a warm country, so you can imagine I wasn't dressed properly. And other people came there. Everybody was deported. And they interviewed me on interviews, asking me questions for 8 hours. And an immigration lady came to me and said, sorry for keeping me here, will let me go. And they opened my bag, and I had this Bible there.
Mm-hmm.
And the lady looked at me and said, are you a priest? And I looked at her, and I wanted to curse her. I wanted to call upon fire to devour her. And I looked at her and I said, the Lord bless you.
Amen. Hallelujah.
And I left. Now, before I came out, there was a lady, a Ghanaian lady, that they wanted to send back because they suspected her that she had some drugs or whatever. So this immigration lady stopped me and said, are you a Ghanaian? I said, yes. Can you help? So I became a translator. She spoke to me. I listened to the lady and I tell her this, and I was there when she was discharged.
Amen.
When I came out, God said, it was because of that lady.
Oh.
That is why I put you there.
Amen.
There's a reason for everything you do. There's a reason.
Amen.
Yeah. Stop murmuring. That is why when I pray, things happen. Because I've been there. And God knows that I will trust Him with my life. And when I call, He said, I will answer.
Yes.
He will answer. He has to. Oh, He has to answer. It is because you are not calling. When you call, God will answer.
Amen.
And then they said, oh, we wanted to go and drop. I said, no, you don't need to drop me. I'm fine. And I came out. So when I came out, I was not scared of immigration. Yeah? I was not scared of the police because I was there with them for 8 hours. God knew the challenges I was going to go through, so He prepared me over there.
Amen.
The things you are going through, it is because of the challenges I have.
It
is because of someone. That is why you are going through that.
Amen.
Don't depart. Don't quit. Wait.
Glory to God.
He said, blessed is the man that endures temptation. For when he's approved of God, you receive what? A crown of glory. There is something awaiting you.
Amen.
Most of us, we quit too early. You come to church, one, two, nothing is happening. Oh, I need to change. I need to change church. I need to change the pastor. No, you need to change yourself.
Yes, sir.
Not the pastor. You need to change yourself, not the church.
Amen.
God is there. Go to Him. You come in, there was nobody here. Said, nowadays the members are not coming. Are you calling them? Call them and find out what is happening to them. Love them. You are sick one month. Nobody calls you. Said, oh, as for this church, they don't care. Really? Do you care? Take the word. Do something. Yeah? Do something. God is counting on you. That is why you are here. He loves you and He wants you to succeed.
Amen.
Yeah? I want you to succeed. That when we stand before the Ayah, you will not be ashamed.
Amen.
I don't want to get to God and God begin to open my eyes and say, listen, you could have achieved all these things. You'd be disappointed. That's why there was a part in, I think, Revelation when you read it, said some people were weeping. Yeah? You've gotten to heaven and you are weeping. Why? Because some of us underachieved. They realized that there was a lot they could have done. They didn't do. So when they screen everything, they say, oh, wow, I've wasted my life. I don't want you to get there and be disappointed. Let's work together. Let's help one another. Let's do it together and make God proud. Yeah, let's make God proud. Let's make God proud. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Every hand's lifted up. I want you to talk to God.